hope you're having a wonderful Sunday morning. We're going to do a couple of songs. We're going to watch our Bible story video. I'm going to give you guys an awesome challenge to do. We'll talk about the Bible video. We'll pray. And after the video, there will be crafts that you can do that will tie into your Bible lesson, as well as activity pages. So we're going to start with As the World Shakes. Do a dance. Trying to get all your Sunday morning wiggles out. Alright, ready?
No matter what I'm gonna face tomorrow, I build my life on everything you say. Turn the light on, now I see forever. The path is clearer out in front of me. I put one foot in front of the other, keeping my eyes on you. My life following Jesus, I trust you, I trust you.
Ready, guys?
As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything.
You're gonna do the same thing again. Ready?
No matter what I'm gonna face tomorrow, I build my life on everything you say. Turn the light on, now I see forever. The path is clearer out in front of me. I put one foot in front of the other, keeping my eyes on you. My life following Jesus, I trust you, I trust you. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything.
So this is the part that we can just kind of dance it out and just like praise the Lord. And then we're about to scream shake, shake. So whenever I point to the camera, I want you to scream shake, shake, shake. 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 Ready?
As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything. As the world shakes, shakes, and things break, break, you are my rock, my everything.
Good job, guys. I'm really proud of you. So, in a moment, we're going to do Freedom Hymn. And this is a song that we're practicing for our Easter program. So, this way you'll have the motions and you can practice at home. Alright, so let's get that started. Freedom Hymn.
I push, I pull, go back and forth, finding myself. Pounding on a locked door, I try to make it out alone without your help. But I know I'll never win this war. I can never be free without you. I can never be me without you. This is the sound of chains breaking. This is the beat of a heart changing. This is the song of a soul forgiven. This is my family. This is my freedom hymn, my freedom hymn. This is my freedom hymn.
During our Jesus ministry, he did more than just heal people, feed people, and preach to people. He also took time to rest and spend time with friends. Three of his closest friends were Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, two sisters and their brother. Jesus spent time at their home in the village of Bethany, enjoying meals, conversation, and wonderful fellowship. While Jesus was far away with his disciples, he received news that Lazarus had become very ill. Jesus was saddened by this, and learned that Mary and Martha were hoping that he would come back and heal Lazarus. Though Jesus loved Lazarus, he decided not to go. 2 days later, Jesus still did not go to Lazarus. Then warnings came that Lazarus died. Everyone was sad, especially Lazarus's family. Jesus was deeply sad as well. Jesus told the disciples that Lazarus was just asleep. Jesus was trying to explain to them that he was more powerful than death. But the disciples could not understand it. In the end, they went to Lazarus' home. When he finally arrived at the house, Jesus learned that his dear friend Lazarus had been dead for 4 days. Many friends and family members were there, grieving with the sisters. Mary and Martha were mourning their brother, weeping, and wishing that Jesus had come sooner. If I had been here, my brother wouldn't have died, Martha sobbed when she saw Jesus. Jesus spoke to her tenderly. Your brother will rise again. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me will not die, but live. Jesus, along with the crowds of mourners, went to Lazarus' tomb. When he arrived at the spot, Jesus wept. As the onlookers saw Jesus weeping, they knew that he loved Lazarus deeply. Jesus was sad for Lazarus, but more so, he was sad that these people had such small faith. He was going to show them again that with God, anything was possible. So Jesus went and stood in front of the tomb and commanded, "Take the stone away." Martha protested, "Lord, there will be an order, for he has been dead 4 days." Jesus looked at her. "Believe, and you will see the glory of God." Then Jesus prayed to God and shouted, "Lazarus, come out!" Then he came. Lazarus, still bound up with his burial attire, came out of the tomb. The crowd reacted in absolute surprise. Jesus had just commanded the dead to come to life. The family was reunited. Lazarus had become sick and died, now emerged from the tomb as healthy as any other man. It was true. Jesus is the resurrection and the life. That day, as a result of what Jesus did, many people believed.
So that was our Bible story video. My challenge for you guys is to reenact the Bible story. So whether you dress up, if you have spare toilet paper, dress yourself up as Lazarus, and if your parents let you, ask first, or put on a white bed sheet or something, and then have your mom or dad or one of your siblings pretend to be Jesus and say, "Lazarus, come out and arise." Per se. But here's my challenge. Do the, while you're reenacting out the Bible story, I want you to film it and I want you to post it on our Facebook page or our Instagram. And I would love to see those different videos. So let's talk about our Bible story a little bit. So the Bible story shows Jesus' power and that many people came to believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And it also gives us a good example of how God uses something bad and turns it into something good. A little bit of background about the Bible story is, so we've gone over the life of Jesus. We've been doing that for the last couple of weeks. We've talked about Jesus turning water into wine, and Jesus feeding 5,000, Jesus walking on water. So there's been all these different miracles. And even though people were seeing Jesus do these miracles, people still weren't believing that he was the Son of God. And so here comes one of his dearest friends, Lazarus, and he's sick. And they're like, oh, Jesus is going to heal him. He's healed other people. Well, Jesus decided not to, and he decided to stay. And he knew that God had a plan and a purpose. This miracle of bringing Lazarus back to life showed a lot of people that he truly was the Son of God. Like, oh, they believed that Jesus could do something like heal somebody who was blind or make them walk again, but they didn't think Jesus had enough power to bring someone back to life. And that's kind of what we're going to talk about. I have like three main points. My first one is Jesus has power over everything. So Jesus knew before Mary and Martha even gave word to him that Lazarus was sick. And he knew before he got word that Lazarus had already died. And he knows all these things and he has power over all these things and he's in control of everything. Even when people didn't recognize that Jesus already knew and that Jesus was in control of the situation. And they doubted, of just what I talked about, that Jesus could actually bring someone back from the dead. So in our lives right now, we're like, things are crazy and we don't have a lot of control over a lot of things. And we're like, how in the world are we going to get through this? Well, we need to remember that Jesus has power over everything, so that no matter what happens, Jesus is in control and he's going to get us through this. My second point is that Jesus knows everything. He knew exactly what was going to happen. He knew that people were going to doubt him and not believe in him, but he also knew that the outcome beforehand, that Jesus he was going to bring Lazarus back to life. He knows what is going to happen. And just like in our situation right now, he knows what's going to happen. You guys might not know when you're going to go back to school. Again, if you're going back to school at all, when we'll be able to come to church and go out and interact with each other. We don't know that. But here's the thing, Jesus knows that. He knows what is going to happen, and we just need to trust him. Just like we talked about on Thursday in our devos, that we don't have to be afraid because God is in control and he gives us peace. And so we just need to lean into Jesus and trust him because he knows everything. My last point is that Jesus has a purpose for everything. Even bad things, some good things can happen. All right? This was Jesus' friend, and he died, and it was sad, and Jesus was really saddened by that. I don't know if you've had someone close to you or maybe a pet that you've lost, and it makes you really sad, right? Well, Jesus was really sad, and you're like, how could something good come out of that? I have some people close to me that have passed, and what God did through that situation, he brought some healing to those family members. And some people even came to know him through that situation. And yeah, it was sad. And it's the same situation in our Bible story today. Jesus was sad that Mary and Martha had lost their brother and he had lost a friend, but he was more sad that people didn't recognize that Jesus could bring Lazarus back to life, that people weren't recognizing him as the true Son of God. So in our situation right now, people are sick, and Jesus knows that people are getting sick, and we're wondering, what is the whole reason for this? We have questions and maybe not a whole lot of answers, but I believe one of the reasons that we're going through this and a purpose that Jesus and God has for this whole situation is this is giving us the perfect opportunity to use all of our social media platforms and reach out to our friends and tell them about Jesus. This can be scary, and there's a lot of people who don't know Jesus, and they're afraid, and they're not sure what is going to happen, and this is the time to be a light to them and show them that we love them, and more importantly, that Jesus loves them. So another challenge that I have for you is to share the love of Jesus with people, because this is something, just like in our Bible story, so many people came to know Jesus because he brought Lazarus back to life. So many people can come to know Jesus and the situation that we're in because we can show the love of Jesus to all of our friends. So our Bible verse for this week is, and it's our memory verse, is John 11:25-26. And Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. And whoever lives by believing in me will never die. Do you believe this? So apply this Bible story to your life. Because if we believe that Jesus is the resurrection and life, we'll live forever no matter what happens. But also start asking your friends, do you believe this? Do you believe that Jesus is the one that you can depend on through everything no matter what happens? And this is a great time for you to just reach out and share Jesus to all of your friends. Let's pray. And then I'll talk a little bit about the activities that are on the website. Dear Jesus, thank you for this time that we get to dig into your word, Lord. Thank you that we can just depend on you for everything. You're in control of every situation. You have power over everything. You know everything, and you have a purpose for everything, Lord. So we're just going to lean into you and trust you. I pray that these kiddos are embraced by your comfort and by your love, Lord, in this situation and what's going on with their lives. But I also pray that they become bold and that they become lights for you, Lord, that they share your love with other kids their age and share your gospel and just help their friends, whether they have questions or they're afraid, Lord, that their friends come to know you, Lord. And I'm just so thankful for this time that we get to worship and praise you, and that you love us so much. In your holy name I pray, amen. All right, guys, I will see you Tuesday for another short devotional. On the website, there is links for a craft and different activities that tie directly with the lesson that you can do at home. I hope you have a wonderful day. I would love to hear any of your prayer requests and what's going on in your life, feel free to reach out to me through Facebook or our Instagram page. And I hope you have a great week. See you Tuesday. Bye.